Sometimes, the best way to give something in a mix more power and more energy is to take energy and power away from other mix elements. Take, for example, this kick. It sounds really good on its own, it's very sharp and defined, but the minute I re-enter it into the mix by unsoloing, it's competing with all kinds of other energy, especially low-end energy coming from other elements in this mix. To give more power to my kick, I'm going to take low-end energy away from other mix elements, and I can do it super easily by going over to my kick, opening up my Neutron, and I have Neutrons and mix tabs scattered all over the tracks in this session, which means I can go to my masking meter, take a look at what's happening on my bass, and make some EQ moves. So I can see that we have a little bit of masking here coming from the bass and the kick. So I'm going to take energy away from the bass. I'll right click to choose a steeper slope. I'll do a high pass. I'll do the same thing for the main drum. Up the sensitivity meter. So it's showing me a little bit of masking over here. Turn on that high pass filter again. Shave off a little bit of energy from those drums. Not so much that they disappear. So for tracks in your mix to talk to each other, it doesn't have to be Neutron to Neutron. For example, I can go over here, I've soloed my marimba track, and I can place a lightweight mix tap plugin on this channel. Now I'll go find this track in the masking meter. There it is right there. And we get instant feedback information via the pink chutes and also the northern lights. So to shave away some of the low end from the marimbas so that they don't compete with the kick, we have a high pass filter right on the mix tap. We can choose our slope and just cut all of the low end from the marimba. Let's end with a big before and after, before I did any high passing on my mix taps or my Neutrons, and then we'll do after.
I'm feeling distant. Can't make this real.